Ahora me reúno con Christopher, un productor de leche y amante de las vacas. La relación que se genera aquí entre animales y humanos es realmente de no creer.
Vamos a conocer a Christopher, el dueño de este predio, para que nos cuente cómo son las buenas prácticas que se realizan aquí en Finlandia con respecto al trato animal y a la producción láctea.
Hola Christopher, ¿qué tal?
Hello, ¿cómo?
Durante la mañana estuvimos viendo, visitando la cooperativa donde ustedes entregan la leche. Nos contaron que ustedes son el mayor proveedor, ¿es así?
Yeah, we are producing milk for OCO. Yep.
¿Y tienen una capacidad de cuántos? ¿Cuántos animales hay en este campo?
We have around 300 milking cows, a little bit more. So we have around 10,000 liters of milk every day. Yeah.
Wow. ¿Cómo hacen ustedes con tanto animal para alimentarlo de forma natural, para tener un buen trato animal?
We have 12 people are working on this farm, plus me and my girlfriend. So yeah, we're trying our best, but it's a lot of work.
En esta parte están las crías.
Yeah, this is the young cows. It's mostly females. We try to get only females. The bulls we sell to another farm, who grow them up and make beef of them, and we only save the heifers by ourselves and get milk cows from them.
Este espacio está súper bien pensado. ¿Ustedes lo distribuyeron así? ¿Este diseño es de ustedes?
Yeah, this is working real good for cows. They really like when they got a lot of air and fresh air and we give them milk here.
Aquí ponen la leche.
Normally we give them milk and that 3 times a day, and then they have some food inside here, and then we put fresh straw and everything inside, so they will keep dry.
¿Y se les alimentan con mamaderas?
The first time we feed them with that, for the new cows, we feed them with that, and then when they get older and knows about drinking about that, then they start to drink from this.
Ah, okay.
But the first time we go inside and feed them by hand for this.
¿Son distintas razas? ¿Hay una mezcla de animales aquí? ¿Mayoritariamente cuáles tienen?
We have 2 different species. We have the Finnish Asia and the Black Holstein. Here we have some beef cows. They are sometimes we get that from the cows. All the cows we inseminated by ourselves. So, and then we sometimes inseminate a cow with the beef bull, and then we get this.
Los terneros pasan los 2 primeros meses de vida alimentándose y refugiándose en sus propios cubículos especiales. En este lugar realmente existe el bienestar animal.
¿Qué edad tiene esta ternera?
10 days, I think. 10 or 11 days.
¿Cuánto tiempo pasan con su madre o son separadas automáticamente?
No, it's like 24 hours with the mother, and then we take them off to this and we start to give them milk by ourselves.
En general, los granjeros aquí tienen una relación con sus vacas, incluso le ponen nombre. Cuando se tienen más de 300 vacas, obviamente eso no se puede hacer. ¿Cómo se instruye al personal para que traten a los animales, digo, con suficiente cariño?
I don't think 300 is not so much. When you have that, you get used to it. But of course, you need to know exactly which animal who is which, and you learn. You have the number and the ears, and you know every cow, every animal.
¿Hay alguna regulación para el trato de los animales aquí? O sea, ¿esto está normado o es una iniciativa propia?
It's a lot of regulations, what you can do and what you don't can do. So you really need to know what you're doing. And it's a really big around everything. You need to have the registration right on the which number every cows are, where they are from, where they have them. You need to have a lot of. So it's a lot of regulations, and it's not something anybody can just start with. You need to have everything, every permissions and everything like that before you can start. So it's quite hard. The buildings, everything, you need the veterinarian have to say that it's good before you can start to build. So it's really hard regulated everything. Everything, every cow, every animal needs some square meters, how much water it gets. So it should be safe that it really gets so much water it wants. We have a lot of for everything. How much food it can eat. It's a regulation for everything here.
El valor agregado del producto de esta cooperativa es que son alimentadas con pasto 100% natural.
Yeah. In the beginning, it's really easy because if the cows are happy, the farmers are happy. If you don't treat the cows really good and give them the best food, you don't get a lot of milk from them. So it's easy. It's just to give what the cows really want and what they need, and then you get the milk back.
Vamos a ver.
Welcome to my house.
Yes. Yeah. Hay que sacarse tradición nórdica para fuera los zapatos y vamos por conocer la caja. ¿Está aquí en el refrigerador?
Yeah.
¿Y dónde está? Cha 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 cha. No. ¿Cómo pasó esto?
Yeah. Yeah, exactly. They called me. They just want to have a new picture on the milk, and they called me and said if they can come out and take some pictures. So we just took one cow, who was really nice, and we take some pictures together with the cows.
Oye, ¿y esto fue una colaboración para esta cooperativa? ¿No es algo que tú hayas cobrado para hacer esta fotografía?
Yeah, no, it's a small company, a small dairy company, and we all need to make as good as we can. So I get no pay for that.
¿Hacemos un brindis?
Yeah, yeah. Make a share, yeah.
Salud, Christopher, muchas gracias. Salud. Por haberme recibido.